This is our presentation on wearable technology. I'm Stuart Winsby.
And I'm Brian Bessinger. Today we're going to look at what is wearable technology, the history of wearable technology, its entertainment uses, its health purposes, some sport uses, and the future of wearable technology. Technology is science or knowledge put into practical use to solve problems or invent tools. Based on this definition, wearable technology has been around for a very long time. From the early invention of shoes, eyeglasses, hearing aids, mouthpieces, and even pedometers, humans have been using wearable technology for a very long time. Nowadays, though, when we think of wearable technology, we think of electronic wearable technology. This would include the shoe inserts that measure pressure, 3D eyeglasses, modern-day hearing aids, a sleep apnea machine that has a mouthpiece that someone wears to be able to help them sleep at night, and even electronic motion sensing pedometers. So for this presentation, when we say or you see wearable technology, we're talking about the electronic type of wearable technology.
Okay, a brief history on wearable technology. Wearable technology has been around for about 40 years or so now. As you can see in this diagram, in 1975 it was the first calculator was invented. The Sony Walkman was invented in 1979. It was a small portable device that you could take music with you, download music onto. The first phone, first BlackBerry here you can see was invented, and it was first where you could get your mail on your go. You can get different like forms of BlackBerry media where you could text each other had different BlackBerries. The first iPhone was invented in 2007. Basically, obviously, iPhone and Apple have changed the world. Obviously, they invented the first iPod. The GoPro was 2004. Obviously, you get to see for different sports, usually for golf, for mountain biking and stuff like that. You get all those cool videos of people coming down mountains on their bikes and stuff. Okay, entertainment usage. So obviously you can see here, watches is a big thing now. Obviously you can, it stops you having to bring your phone out of your pocket every time. You can see your notifications, your messages, your emails and stuff. And obviously you get all your different apps that's on your watches. Obviously you just need to have your phone with you, you don't have to take it out of your pocket. Google Glass is actually pretty cool. Basically, it's just a set of glasses that you put on, and it ever in the front of your eyes. So you can say to Google Glass, bring me up a checklist, and it'll bring it right up in front of your eyes, just like a normal pair of glasses, and you can see what you need to do. Obviously, this here stops you being, you can bring it with you wherever you need to go. You don't have to bring a PC with your computer, so this is pretty cool. Virtual reality, so basically with this virtual reality thing right here, it lets you be in, especially for gaming, it lets you actually be in the game rather than like what everyone else does and be outside, obviously. And basically you can be like your own character and stuff. This is for more like, for obviously like gaming personal things.
The health industry has also been using wearable technology for its advantages. First example is neurological health. Individuals who have diseases such as Parkinson's disease, maybe chronic pain, even depression, now doctors can use electronic devices that will actually stimulate certain parts of the brain that allows them to not have the stimulation or have the stimulation whether they need it or not. For example, someone with some major tremors, stimulating the brain in a certain area can help decrease those tremors a little bit. Modern day healthcare individuals are also using wearable technology. It's helped to minimize human mistakes on taking vitals of patients such as blood pressure, heart rate, pulse rate. So they've been using this wearable technology to not only cut down on the mistakes, but it also allows the nurse or whoever's doing the taking the vitals to step aside, do something else, minimizing the time that it would take for them to actually stand there and manually take a pulse, for example. Health monitoring of our public officials is also becoming more and more advanced. police officers have used wearable technology in the forms of their bulletproof vest for quite a while. However, now we have, for example, firemen are starting to use jackets that not only have maybe the communications antenna and also maybe a GPS tracker, but it can sense the outside temperature and also their internal temperature. This can help give them alerts whether or not they're becoming overheated or not. Firefighters are known for obviously putting their lives on the line. They used to use old manual tests such as their ear test and how hot it got. Well, now this can give them an alert to say, hey, you're getting a little overheated, we need you to step aside. And even if they don't want to, now their bosses can see this information and pull them out. And obviously you have your everyday fitness and lifestyle enthusiasts. These individuals can wear things such as the Fitbit, the Nike Fuel Band, that can monitor not only their calories that they burn, their steps they've taken, their heart rate if they want to train at a certain intensity. And as wearable technology becomes more and more advanced, these instruments are becoming more and more accurate. The sport industry is also using wearable technology for its benefits. The first example is enhancing the sport's performance of an athlete. A coach or a trainer can now use this technology to help their athlete perform better. For example, there are socks now that can measure the pressure on the foot with the ground reaction forces. So if an individual, if they're working on their jumps or they're working on their takeoffs, the athlete or the coach can now analyze this information of how they're doing it, help them become more efficient and better at their sport. You can also use this wearable technology to analyze the motion of the athlete. It may not necessarily be just the body that they're measuring, but also the tool that the athlete is using. For example, a golfer can not only measure the body in terms of the shoulder turn and the hip turn, but also their golf club, which is their tool. They can get statistics such as the club speed and also where the club is in relation to space, which golfers call the club plane. Once again, using all this information takes them back to being able to enhance their sports performance. We're also seeing wearable technology being used to prevent and return from injury. Sports such as football, hockey, rugby, they're starting to use technology on their pads to tell how hard they're getting hit by whether it's a competitor or whether or not when they hit the ground. So the NFL has been using this kind of technology now in their helmets to be able to learn more and more about concussions and how they can prevent them and bring athletes back from concussions. Returning from injury, a coach or an athletic trainer can now have a basis of what an athlete is when they are 100% healthy. And then when they're coming back from an injury, they can use that information to say, okay, I only want you to go 50%, and they can see how that relates to their base information. Athletes are known for wanting to come back too quickly from injury, and this way the coach or the trainer can now have a little bit more control to say, you can go a little bit harder, or you need to back off and rest a little bit, because obviously we want you back as soon as we can at 100%. So the old adage and the old saying of practice makes perfect is no longer valid. Now it's perfect practice makes perfect, and wearable technology has given us the opportunity to do that.
Okay, so where is the wearable technology going in the future? So obviously here you can see smaller and more powerful computers. Obviously you can get computers nowadays that can fit, basically this size, that can fit in your purse, your handbag or whatever. Then you can take them everywhere you want. Obviously iPads and obviously your iPhones now that you can get, that obviously basically is a computer and does everything for you nowadays. Solar powered with charging capabilities. So now obviously you can see this jacket here, which has like a solar panel on the back. And that basically attracts the heat, obviously, or the sunlight, and gives you a capability of charging your phone or charging a portable device that you might need. Artificial intelligence, obviously, this is pretty cool. Obviously, for people that have lost limbs and stuff for various different reasons. So, like you can see in this picture, a hand, obviously a mechanic hand, and the hand basically can feel that the pressure of the other hand and knows that it's basically programmed. It knows it's shaking a hand and it does do what it needs to do, so like compress and squeeze the other hand. And you can obviously program the arm to do plenty of different things. Everyday life connections, obviously, technology, like we're saying, is growing and growing. So nowadays you can have the sensors on the garage, that when your car pulls up, the garage door comes up. Obviously, you can control your AC, your lights, and everything on your phone and through many different devices. And basically, mainly everything in your house can be controlled by a handheld device. Obviously, this brings privacy issues and all devices, especially in your household. Obviously, if everything's through a network or whatever, through connections, then obviously hackers will be able to even get in through your guides, get into your house, control your AC, control your lights. Obviously, you've seen it in movies, but obviously, nowadays it's becoming more and more popular reality, and obviously, more and more people are starting to put it into different houses and stuff like that. Here's a bit about the stock exchange, stocks and stuff about each company. So, Fitbit here is worth $3.2 billion, and the stock price is actually $6.66 as of today for Fitbit. Obviously, Apple is probably one of the most known, obviously, companies for technology, and it's worth $584 billion, which is ridiculous. And it's each stock price is $156 for just one. Garmin, which is basically like a GPS system you can use it for in your car, or some golfers actually use it to map out different golf courses and give them yardages to the hole. Obviously, they're only worth $10 billion. They're a growing company, and the shares are only $12 a piece. And then Samsung, the last one, is worth $172 billion. Obviously, they're the electronic phones, TVs, other different devices, and each share price is $120. And these four companies are, if you're going to invest in a wearable device a company, these four would be your best bet. But experts have said that these are the top four at the minute and will be for the next number of years. That's our presentation on wearable technology. I'm Stuart Winsby.
And I'm Ryan Bessinger.